Yo, we are here. All for the podcast. It is your boys, me and John, this week. We have a lot to talk about. Mostly this will be NFL wise. It's not a lot of news on NBA. So we're going to do a little bit of a mini NFL episode. Plus, NFL season is almost around the corner. So we'll be talking about a lot of stuff down the road, training camps, fantasy football, drafts and no drafts coming down the road, and a lot of other stuff. So Ball Central Podcast, down below, you can check us on all your podcasting platforms. And we have two YouTube channels, one for the podcast, which you're watching right now, and the gaming channel, where we do a lot of games, NBA, NFL, WWE, et cetera, et cetera. So that being said, John, how are you doing this week?
I'm doing real good. Doing really, really good. Went to the beach somewhat this week, took some pictures. Yeah, I mean, doing a good time. Very good time. What about you, Phil? How's your week?
Pretty good. Just did a lot of, you know, working on the gaming channel, doing WWE and MLB content, so that's hot right now. NBA and NFL content coming very soon because Madden comes out next month, I believe August 18th, I believe, or somewhere between the second week of August, so excited about that. Hopefully it's not, you know, the same trash product we get every year. So
it might be, it might not. We'll have to see.
But they do have crossplay this year, so we'll see how that goes.
Okay.
So, also, I'm pretty good. Happy to talk with my boy John, another Ball Central Knight.
Oh yeah.
So we have a lot of NFL to talk about. So let's get on with the show. So first one, I'll just get this one out the way first. The Hard Knocks will be featured by John's very own New York Jets.
Jets, baby, let's go.
So they were no one wanted to do it this year. For obvious reasons, they're very personal. They want to record everything. And the Jets were forced to do it because they were like one of the five teams that the NFL can force to do it. And with Aaron Rodgers and all the stuff going on with the Jets this year, they were the obvious choice to get forced to do it. So
we basically have our own Hard Knocks as it is in FS, like it's like Flight Force or something. I don't know. It's a YouTube series, which I mean, now we'll get a Hard Knocks. It'll be interesting. I mean, I'm excited to see a little bit of it.
Yeah. Also, I think they didn't mention one small detail is they're not going to show players getting cut because they thought that'd be not humane or inhumane, as they would say. So most of the Hard Knocks episodes, we see people get cut, traded, signed, et cetera, et cetera. So they will not be showing that aspect of it.
That's good. I like that.
So how much of the time do you think the cameras will be around Aaron Rodgers?
I think a good portion of the time. I mean, he's used to being mic'd up. Am I right? Like the NFL films and stuff have done stuff with him. I mean, he's done stuff with Pat McAfee. He's, you know what I mean? He's someone who can take the pressure. So I'm excited to see what he does this year. And I'm excited to see how hard he works. And I mean, what I hear is he's a very hard worker and the Jets are very excited. And I mean, I don't know, Phil. I mean, I know I'm wearing a Giants hat right now, my Knicks shirt. You know what I mean? So no love to the Jets. I know it's blue today, right? I'm feeling a little blue for Saquon. All right. I'm standing in solidarity right now. But like, no, it's just, I don't know. I don't think it'll be such a distraction where like things break down. But I also do like how they're not including cutting people because I remember on previous episodes, they talked about how people like weren't like grown enough yet, or you know what I mean? They talked about certain people and why they were getting cut, and it was inhumane. You know what I mean? Like you're kicking somebody when he's down. You know what I mean? Like this is their NFL dreams, and I mean, I'm hoping it works out for everybody. You know what I mean? But most of the time, it doesn't. So it's just, I mean, I'm excited to see some Hard Knocks. What about you, Phil?
I'm gonna be honest with you. I haven't watched one episode of Hard Knocks ever.
Ever? All right, this year's got to be the year. You got to watch one episode at least. The Jets.
Okay.
All right.
Where is it, on HBO Max? Where is it on?
Yeah. It's on Max. HBO got cut from it, so it's just Max now. But
I haven't seen one episode of Hard Knocks ever. So
word. Well, I mean, if you don't have it, I'll send you the link or whatever. You know what I mean? Like, we gotta get you to watch one. You know what I mean?
Or we could do a live watch, or we could watch and react to it.
Facts. That would be also very cool.
Okay. Yes, I'll watch it.
Word. And I haven't yet seen Quarterback. Did Elijah give us that recommendation last week? Did you watch any of them yet?
No, I am terrible with watching shows as of late.
Okay. Well, I saw some off TikTok, some like clips or whatever. And I think Elijah was right.
The one with Crosby?
Yeah, the one with Crosby, the one with
that's the only one I saw on TikTok.
So. Oh, okay. I mean, there's a lot of Mahomes just being Mahomes, as in, like, he gets reaction, like, when he has to, like, go get something looked at an x-ray, he's super pissed.
They got renewed for season two as well.
Oh, did they? Okay, I wonder who they're doing for three quarterbacks. I think that's going to be interesting.
Josh Allen got to be one of them.
He should be. I mean, I
for me, Josh Allen, Trevor Lawrence.
It's hard.
And
I think they should do it kind of like they did it with this season because, like, Patrick Mahomes is the quarterback. You know what I mean? So, who else did they have? They had
Mariota, Cousins, and Mahomes.
Okay, so the quarterback, a veteran, and then
new guy.
I guess a new guy. Yeah, in a new situation. So, I mean, maybe Derek Carr would be a cool one.
That would be nice, actually.
I don't know. In New Orleans, you know what I mean?
John Gruden is going to be there as well, so I don't know if the camera's going to be on John Gruden.
maybe not. All right. Didn't know John Gruden got hired by New Orleans, but I'm excited. Yeah, did he really?
He's a quarterback specialist.
Quarterback specialist? Really? Okay.
Him and Derek Carr are like this?
Yeah, they are. So, I mean, I like that they're getting back together. All right, that's what's up. You know what I mean?
I think it'd probably be, Josh Allen, Trevor Lawrence, and, probably Derek Carr. I don't know who else would be.
Who'd be in the mix?
Yeah, for, as the veteran.
I think rookie-wise, you could always go, Stroud or, I would love to see Anthony Richardson.
Maybe Jared Goff?
Jared Goff would be
a great one. Because the Lions were on Hard Knocks before.
He's getting a lot of hype. He's getting a lot of hype now.
Goff or Stafford?
True.
Yeah, I like that. Goff or Stafford, to be honest.
I don't know. Matthew Stafford doesn't have a line. So,
exactly.
I mean, it, those episodes would be brutal. I don't know.
Absolutely. Okay. As to talk about the Jets and the Hard Knocks, hey, we'll see how it goes. Everyone loves to keep eyes on Aaron Rodgers, Pat McAfee's show. Everyone loves Aaron Rodgers or hates Aaron Rodgers, depending on how you feel. So, we'll see how it goes. Hopefully, they don't show something too crazy. Maybe Aaron Rodgers might have some. He probably will have his moments on there,
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. Yeah. I'm waiting for him to. He's going to shine, and people are going to look up to him.
He's going to pull a Kyrie, and before every game, he's going to walk around with Sage on stage.
That would be crazy. That'd be crazy, but it would be interesting.
I wouldn't doubt it.
If they win, Phil, they'll follow him. You know what I mean? I'm just saying, that's what's scary about the Jets is that last year they were a young team who needed a quarterback. Who do we bring in? Aaron Rodgers. You know what I mean? So, they're going to be a young team with a good quarterback, and it's going to be fun to watch.
Gotcha. Speaking of teams without a good quarterback, the Tennessee Titans. They signed DeAndre Hopkins over the weekend.
Raise a glass, Phil. Why? Yeah. Because we're celebrating. Hopkins didn't get signed by the Bills nor the Dolphins, so raise a glass. Gotcha. Absolutely. Yeah. Hopkins, congratulations on your situation. Maybe you think you're going to win out. Maybe you will. Who knows? You know what I mean? I'm just – Phil, Hopkins is different than Julio. You know what I mean? He is different.
Of course, but still, you can see this for me a variety of different ways. As John sees it, he's not in our division, or he didn't went to AFC powerhouse. Good for our teams; we don't have to deal with that. Mm-hmm. The Titans are debatable; they're maybe middle of the road type of team. So, I guess because you have Derrick Henry, because that's always a tough person to stop.
But they have Burke on the outside; he can be the number two now. Last year he was the number one, and he was struggling. Now he can be a number two and just get the ball. Yeah. And he's growing. You know what I mean? And then you got Hopkins. And then
Tannehill get on the ball, though?
Can Tannehill get on the ball? Or are you going to go with Will Levis? You never know. Are you going to go with a rookie?
It's got Malik Willis on the roster, too.
You still got Malik Willis. I mean, you got all these options. Mm-hmm. I'm excited to see what happens. They're a defensive-minded team, too. Put that on the roster.
You could – for that – and that type of, perspective of John, it was he's not going to be fair. He's not going to be playing for AFC powerhouse. That's, that's a good thing. Yeah. Patriots and Jets don't have to worry about him. Especially if he didn't go to the Dolphins or Bills, so that's good for us.
We're the Chiefs, so we don't have to see him in the Super Bowl. You know what I mean?
Another perspective, he got his bag he wanted. He got paid, good for you. We're more than happy you got the money you wanted. The Patriots offered him the same contract, but it was more incentive-based. So he was, he didn't want to perform, I guess, for us.
You need that upfront money, Phil. What are you talking about? Bill Belichick, I don't know if he put me in at the end of the game if I'm 5 yards out. You know what I mean? Yeah.
And then the other perspective, which I'm seeing it as, for his career, what are you going to do in Tennessee? Are you going to compete for a championship in Tennessee? Plus, I don't know how old he is, but he's up there in age. He's close to, being out the door. Don't you want to try to compete for a championship? Don't you want to try to win something? You make it to a conference championship before you retire, at least. Because the Cardinals or Texans haven't been close to that ever since. And now he's going to a team that hasn't been one to – did they went to one before, like previous years? Maybe second round?
Yeah, yeah. They've been to the conference championship. And they've been – no, they've been to the Super Bowl once. You know, yeah.
A while ago.
Yeah, yeah, a while ago. I mean, it was the – they lost by a touchdown. It was crazy. You know what I mean? But
it's just tough that, you know, you spend all your career on bad teams. Cardinals, you can say it was a bad team because they never did nothing ever happened with the Cardinals and Kyler Murray.
And I don't mean to say it like as in such a business perspective, but like Tennessee is one of the states people are flocking to. Why? One, Nashville, great city. Two, no state income. So he's not paying taxes. You know what I mean? Man's getting $20 million to just play football. You know what I mean? Doesn't have to worry about anything. I mean, that's such a great way of looking at it. And it just, I don't know. I'm happy for him. I know he probably won't win anything. Like, do you think he probably won't win a Super Bowl? You know what I mean? The right. Titans would have to catch on fire, which they could, but I don't know. I don't know if I believe in Ryan Tannehill like that. Maybe Will Levis. I don't know.
Exactly.
But I think he will help with the quarterback situation in Tennessee. You know what I mean? Like he's a productive wide receiver.
I mean, they always are run first, so we'll see how that goes.
And that helps wide receivers in the long run. You know what I mean? To be run first offense.
Yeah, we can't stack the box now.
Okay. Thanks.
And also, some running backs, you know, John's also very upset. A certain running back didn't get paid with the deadline, I think, a couple days ago. Three running backs didn't get paid and will now be free agents next year. Josh Jacobs, Tony Pollard from the Cowboys, and Saquon Barkley from the Giants. John, I know how you feel about this, so I'll just go first.
Thank you. I'm a big fan of Saquon Barkley. I'm a big fan of who he is as a person, him in the locker room being a leader. I think he was great for our team. I think he was great for Daniel Jones last year. He stayed healthy last year. I think these were all caliber things to get him a new contract. And I think the Giants are one of many teams that are using running backs.
Oh.
I mean, to their potential. I mean, to just use them for their youth. You know what I mean? So,
side note: next year's draft free agent class is loaded for running backs: Derrick Henry, Josh Jacobs, Saquon Pollard, Eckler, and Jonathan Taylor. So, someone's getting paid in that offseason.
I mean, I would hope. You know what I mean? Everyone, but probably. Like, but in what 2 years, 3 years? How many years are they going to get? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's like I'm not saying like these players don't get paid. Like I'm not saying. But I would say the vast majority of running backs do not get paid based on like league minimums. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
At least for the position, because I mean, if you're not a prove it running back, you're on a prove it contract. You know what I mean? And a prove it contract is basically nothing. Right. So, yeah. I mean, I don't know. I hope they do something in the player bargaining agreement with this. I think this needs to be the main focus of the next one. Is to get these guys paid, especially these young running backs. You know what I mean? But I don't know. I'm really hoping a deal can get done. I don't know how a deal can get done, but I'm really hoping a deal can get done between Barkley and the Giants because I'd love to see him again in blue. You know what I mean?
Yeah, because a lot of these guys are vital to their offenses. Josh Jacobs, he was the leading rusher last year. Tony Pollard, there's no more Zeke, and you need him for your offense, or you have no running backs.
Watch, they'll go get Zeke.
They could go
resign him for like what, $2 million deal? The veteran minimum. Like, so I mean, he didn't perform well. No one's offering him a contract.
Right.
Like, but does he sell out Pollard? Do you know what I mean? Because you look at the Giants, you look at the Cowboys. Who else is thinking about holding out? Was it the Raiders with Josh Jacobs?
Yeah, Josh Jacobs, Pollard.
Okay.
Look at
all those teams. They all need a running game, and they all do not have a running game without those players.
Yeah.
It's not like the Minnesota situation with Cook. Like, Cook was released from Minnesota, and they have, what is it, Madison? Or I can't remember who their backup was last year. He was number four. But he's going to fill in for Cook. You know what I mean? So now Cook's waiting on a deal, but he's probably not going to find something until training camp or – a couple weeks before training camp, or I don't know, maybe he'll take a friendly deal somewhere else. But I mean, I don't know. I don't know what's going on. And there's a bunch of people that haven't been signed yet, like Dalton Risner. He's a guard. I mean, like the Rams need guards. Go talk to that guy for a veteran minimum. I don't know. There's Marcus Peters, who's a corner. The Jets could use that guy. You know what I mean?
How old is he?
Marcus Peters?
Yeah.
The corner? Yeah. There's Genevieve Clowney. He's still – I mean, that could do good.
I think all those guys are high in age. That's why, maybe.
I get that. I mean, there's Justin Houston still 34. I get it, high in age. But, like, bro, you could sign these guys and they could be rotational players. Like, Ndamukong Suh helped the Eagles go to the Super Bowl last year. Whether you want to believe it or not, he was a rotational player who brought a lot to that defensive line. And if not him, like, he took up space at least. You know,
he'll eat up for, like, what, 4 or 5 pivotal plays?
Yeah, I mean, a game maybe. But, like, but they were pivotal plays. He was in on a lot of big plays. So, I mean,
it's tough. You know, the running back position has been disrespected the last couple of years. And we're seeing it a lot. We're seeing it right now. A lot of them deserve a good paycheck because they arguably probably get hit the most out of everyone in the NFL. You know, with all the handoffs, all the screen passes, they do a lot of the dirty work with, you know, pass protection as well. It's tough to see a position get, you know, be treated like this, especially NFL, one of the higher tier ones or like most popular ones.
NFL, let's say those three running backs set out week one. Do the Cowboys, Giants, or Raiders win? Or do their odds go down drastically? Because drastically, now all I have to do is prepare for a freaking pass game. Like, no offense, but like
double team Devontae Adams.
Like, I mean, yeah, that I'll triple team that dude. Like, what do I care? Do you know what I mean? Like the Giants, I mean, they had wide receivers. Now everyone's doubled. You know what I mean? You don't have to put anybody in the box. You could rush three. Like, I don't know. It's gonna be interesting to see what happens. And I don't know. I don't know. Yeah, I'm just annoyed still because I don't want him to hold out, but I understand if he holds out. You know what I mean? Like, it's an understanding thing. Like, he's not going to put his body on the line, you know what I mean, for a team that won't commit 2-3 years to this guy, even though he's the face of the franchise. You know what I mean? And it's, right. I don't know. It's just disheartening.
You look at each offense with the running backs. Saquon Barkley, 50 to 75% heavy usage. You know, Josh Jacobs, leading rusher, and Pollard – I mean, he's your do-it-all back, passing, catching, et cetera, et cetera.
So, he took over that offense last year. He put Zeke on the bench. Like, right. And he had games that, like, I didn't think he would even perform in. The Giants-Cowboys game on my birthday, I was like, this guy, who is this guy? You know what I mean? And he showed me who he was. He was 103 yards. Like, I didn't think he'd get 100, and he got 103 just to stick it to me.
Also, Elijah will be joining us momentarily, setting up right now, so a little bit of delay. He'll be showing up. Also, we have some Madden reactions we want to go over as well. It's next month Madden comes out, so it's officially Madden season. You'll see a lot of Madden on the Ball Central Gaming channel. Last year we started with some, we debuted it. I played as a quarterback and a wide receiver. Did not win Super Bowl neither of them. I tried to win a championship as a wide receiver with Aaron Rodgers on the Green Bay Packers. He sold in the second round of the playoffs.
Did he really?
Yep. Yeah. And then I played as a quarterback for the – I think it was Cowboys or someone else. No, it was quarterback for
– You could win in on America's team. Come on now.
It was someone, but yeah. But Madden season is here, and they released some ratings for like 4 different groups. So I'm just going to pull it up on the screen, and we could – give us our thoughts. There's some players that should be a little higher in the group.
There's some players that should probably be lower too.
Oh. Absolutely. Saquon Barkley. Absolutely.
All right. Don't come on my guy. They probably also rated in contract.
Yeah. So you know, it popped up for you.
Yeah, it popped up.
Okay. So they started off with the wide receiver list. Justin Jefferson is a 99 overall this year. Tyreek Hill, 98, so on. Devontae, Diggs, Kupp, Chase, Hopkins, Terry McLaurin, A.J. Brown, and Amari Cooper. So anything that stands out to you?
Chase's should be 95 or above, personally. Jamar Chase?
Yeah.
Especially when he's paired up with Joe Burrow, who he's known since college, all right? He's a 95. That dude is dangerous. Like, you double-team him a good portion of the game. You know what I mean? So, I don't know. That's me. That's the only thing I would do. You think Cooper should be higher, maybe? I don't know.
Honestly,
maybe
Cooper should be a 92. I agree with Jamar Chase. It should be 95 at least.
Thank you.
A Cooper Kupp, I'm good with. McLaurin. I feel like A.J. Brown should be a little bit higher, don't you think?
A little bit. Maybe a 93.
A 92, 94. 93.
I think Cooper should be 92. He did so much in Cleveland with nothing. Like
Scary Terry too.
Yeah, Scary Terry. I mean, I think some of these guys' ratings also in a way should come down minus one, minus, you know what I mean, just based on quarterback. You know what I mean? Like, is Sam Howell really what it is in, you know what I mean, like in Washington? Maybe not. But maybe he is. Maybe when Sam Howell grade goes up, so should Terry McLaurin. You know what I mean?
Yeah. They obviously adjust him due to in season performance. So if they do good, it goes up. If they do bad, it goes down.
As it should be.
Okay. And the next one, safeties. So Derwin James is your number one. Minkah Fitzpatrick, Justin Simmons, Byard, Jesse Bates, Tyrann Mathieu, Buda Baker, Poyer, Harrison Smith, and Micah Hyde. Honestly, I don't have too much you know, complaints about this.
Jordan Poyer at eight, that's like a little low for me. But
yeah, I mean, seven, eight, and nine are all 90. So you might interchange those.
I don't know. Buda Baker only a 90?
I feel like that is a little low.
That's all I'm saying. Like, some of these are a little low, but I mean, hey, what are you gonna do? I mean,
and he's probably gonna have that rating go up because, you know, there's not much in Arizona now with D-Hop gone, a lot of people. So he'll be playing defense a lot. So.
I like Minkah Fitzpatrick at 93. I like all these 92s and 91s. Those are good. Yeah, I mean, yeah.
Yeah, Poyer and Hyde. I think maybe give Micah a 90. Well, who got injured last year? Poyer, right?
No. Barely. Was he injured for a while?
Yeah, I know Poyer got injured and he was out for he had to miss one of the playoffs.
But he should have been a Pro Bowler. He hasn't been a Pro Bowler the last 2 years, but he should have been one, at least one of those two. You know what I'm saying? Like he's definitely a 90 or above, but I could have put him at 92, to be 100% honest. He's such a leader of that Bills defense.
All right. Okay.
I hope he gets injured again. No offense. I don't know. I hope anyone gets injured, but like as a to play against him, oh my god, so scary.
Right. We have to see him twice a year.
So. Twice a year? You know how hard that is? Absolutely. Like, and then he didn't make the Pro Bowl, so the guy's mad. Yeah. Come on.
So the seventh straight year we have Aaron Donald as a 99 overall. He tied the record for most 99s in a row with Peyton Manning. So congrats to Aaron Donald. Well deserved. Probably
he's gonna break it. He's
top five player in the NFL, so no doubt about that. So Donald, Chris Jones, Dexter Lawrence, Quinnen Williams, Cameron Hayward, Jonathan Allen, Jeffrey Simmons, Vita Vea, DJ Reader, and Christian Wilkins. I mean, Aaron Donald deserves to be 99. So,
if it wasn't for freaking Jason Kelce, Dexter Lawrence would be a 95 or above. But but Jason Kelce is such a good center that Dexter Lawrence is a 94, and that's it.
Right, so you think Quinnen Williams at 93 is fair?
I would also agree that is a little low, but I would say he is way better than 93. I would say more 95-ish. I mean, maybe 96.
96.
I mean, I think he's just as good as Chris Jones. I'm sorry. I don't mean to be like that, but he's just as good, if not better. I'm sorry.
94 at most.
Ooh, that's a little low for
me. He's still a little young. He's still a little young, and he was injured for, what, a good amount of time last year as well?
No, he leads. But, yeah, I hear what you're saying.
Yeah, I mean, he has 96 potential.
What is this disrespect with Christian Wilkerson? What do you call it? 86. This is defensive tackles?
Defensive line. Anyone on the line.
What is that disrespect to 86?
Yeah, I'm guessing D tackles.
And they fall off? Like that? Yeah, like that.
It was like 590.
And where's TJ? Wait, no. This got to be D tackle, Phil. This got to be. Because Watt isn't even on this list.
It's tackles.
I'd be like, Watt's not on this list, and Wilkerson's. Yeah,
they said defensive tackles. I don't know what's the defensive line.
It's annoying. Quinnen Williams, he could play DN too. I mean, he could play literally anything. I mean, so could Dexter Lawrence. They're more in a three other set. I mean, they're more D tackles, but I mean, so could Aaron Donald. He could rush the outside too.
He could do anything he wants.
Yeah, damn. But Vea 88, okay, I guess. But Phil, what do you think about it?
He's gonna be playing a lot of defense, so.
Don't you think 86 is a disrespectful rating?
Elijah, what do you think?
Yeah, how you doing?
Christian Wilkins?
Yeah. I think he's an 87 or above. I don't know. I'm being a little picky now.
Really a big difference, but
I know. But I'm picky with my numbers. Like, I think
I'm a little picky with my numbers too, and I kind of would put him at like a 91. Honestly, he's really dynamic.
Wilkinson, right?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Do you think Quentin Williams is rated a little too low, Elijah? Or that's fine?
I think he's fine. I'll be honest. I'd actually put him a little lower.
Really? I put him 95. I know that's all too biased, but no, he's really damn good. I mean, I think if Donald falls off in 3 years, he's gonna be the one that takes his spot as number one D tackle. Don't you? I mean, maybe you don't. I don't know.
I think because Chris Jones will probably go up there in age as well. So yeah,
that's what I'm saying.
Chris Jones is a edge rusher.
I know. That's why this list is so irritating because TJ Watt's not on it either, and
TJ Watt's a linebacker.
I know. Oh, but he plays the end too, right? Or no?
He's a linebacker.
Oh, okay. Because it's a five.
Yeah.
Got you. Yeah. That's so bold, but I hear what you're saying.
Yeah. They also have.
How often does TJ Watt drop back? You think?
Here's the edge rushers.
Not often.
Okay.
No, they put TJ Watt as edge.
He's right there.
No. Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
F4. Okay.
F4.
94.
F4. Wow.
Hey, Von Miller and Max Crosby at 94.
Wait, are you really trying to tell me there's no 99s at edge rushers right now? No. That's crazy.
Miles Garrett was 99 last year, too.
Michael Parsons is low, too. I
agree with the ranking, but
sure.
Putting these guys at 94, that's a big drop off from 97.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think Max Crosby.
TJ, Max Crosby, like they should all be at least like a 96, 95.
Yeah.
Judon should be at least a 90.
Von Miller definitely should be higher than 94. Maybe even Joey
Bosa. Hassan Reddick should be higher than 90.
Matthew Judon 89 is so fucking disrespectful, Phil. I'm
91 would have been fine, to be honest.
But he was like top three in sacks.
Yeah.
Hassan Reddick at 90 is crazy.
Oh, no.
I love Madden range. Always got to be.
He led him in sacks, too. Did it Reddick who took home number one last year? Who was the one that – was either Reddick or Judon? I'm pretty sure it was Reddick.
I don't remember who it was.
It might have been a pressures thing. I don't know. That's also another category.
NFL sacks leaders 2023.
Could have been like the Parsons for all I know. Who knows?
It was – Bosa, Garrett, Reddick, Jones, Judon.
Okay.
Judon and Jones tied at 15.5. Garrett and Hassan Reddick at 16, and then Nick Bosa at 18.5.
Okay. Nick Bosa. Number one.
Hey, not bad. Okay. Hold on. Elijah, did you see the wide do you want to see the wide receivers and safeties? Here's wide receivers.
Diggs should be 97.
Who?
Diggs.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's already bumped up one.
AJ should be bumped up.
Yeah, AJ brought a 91 is crazy.
D Hop at 93 is cool. I'd put him at 92.
Yeah.
Okay. I'd put Terry at 91. Not his fault.
The quarterback's fault, right?
Yeah.
Yep. What about Chase? No offense. I think with Joe Burrow, especially
Mark Chase at 94 is really crazy.
That's what I'm saying though. You know what? I'm just like, is that not disrespectful? Come on.
He should be higher than Cooper Kupp if I'm being honest.
Why? Because of the injury bug?
Yeah.
I mean, but I'm just saying Cooper Kupp still had a great damn year even with the injury, but you know what I'm saying?
I didn't know his stats last year.
No, he didn't play like the majority like Elijah's saying, but like he did play some damn really good games.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, he should be in 95, 96. I'm saying that Jamar Chase should be a little bit higher because he played the full season.
Sure.
I'd put Kupp at 95, 94. And Jamar Chase, I'd put him at 96, Diggs at 97.
I'd say 95. I'd be fine with that. 94 is like, I hear you. But I hope he doesn't slip that much because that's like age slipping. You know what I mean?
Well, like, D-Hop, I think should be – I think he'd go lower. I think Terry goes lower. I think
you think he's age slipping?
D-Hop?
Yeah. Yeah, how much? What would you put D on that?
91? Half the year.
Yeah, well, there's that too. But we didn't bring Brady or Edelman down when that happened. You know what I mean?
I don't know. Well, Brady was never suspended for half a season.
He had 4 games.
Brady only missed 4 games.
Yeah.
And he's Brady, so you don't get benched automatically. So.
But at the same time, like you saw when he came back, how his play did not drop off. D Hop,
yeah,
his play dropped off a little bit, and at the same time, the reason that he got suspended has to factor into his rating as well.
True, yeah. And he signed with the Titans, so like, who is his quarterback now? You know what I mean? Like, it's gotta, you know what I mean?
I don't really care about that.
I think quarterback definitely factors in a way. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, it does factor. That's why I said Terry should go lower, but
yeah,
I think the rating should be. Oh shoot, hit my laptop. I think the rating should be based on how you played last year.
Yeah.
So for D-Hop, like I said, I'd put him at 82.
Okay. And then before we move on, the safeties. Anything that jumps out for you for the safeties? We said Buda Baker should be a 90.
Buda Baker and Jordan Poyer are just the two for me that, like, I just think they're dynamic players on their defenses. Like,
I'll be honest. Tyrone Mathieu, I love him. Honey Badger.
I mean, he struggled last year. Oof.
I could see him at 89. Exactly. I could see him at 89.
That's it right there. But that's all I'd put him at.
89? Yeah, that's fair. Yeah, first year with the Saints, definitely struggled. He deserved, I don't know, 91, maybe because of his name, but definitely did not have the best year with the Saints last year. Definitely 1989. Other than that, I'm saying
I'm kind of fine with this list.
The only reason I stuck up for Porter was because, like I don't like the Bills, but, like, he did get Pro Bowl snubbed. I mean, I know he was injured last year for a little bit, so maybe that's why his rating's lower, but 2 years ago, he definitely got Pro Bowl snubbed, which is crazy. Like, now one defensive player on the Bills got to the Pro Bowl? Bro, what? Like, what? That's just impossible. I don't know.
So, also, Elijah, how do you feel about the D-Hop going to the Titans?
How do I feel about it? We spoke about this. But
we did spoke about why we want to know on the pod. We want to know on the pod.
This is a terrible decision for somebody who is ring chasing and says that.
Is he ring chasing, especially with this move? I'm just.
He's supposed to.
Say he wanted to go to a team that has a great chance of winning.
Okay.
And a stable management as well.
And you go to Tennessee?
Sort of.
You had Buffalo and Kansas City both talking to you, and you go to Tennessee.
For minimums and taxes.
Like,
he's not going to pay taxes in Tennessee.
That's fine. You can take understand. Money. Like,
I'm just saying. That's
he
a lot
said
of money.
He's ring chasing, but he ended up going for the money.
Yeah. Well, that's what I don't like. He went for the money. I don't believe he's ring chasing. You know what I mean? But I could see them being competitive.
Now we don't believe it because
you know what I mean. Like, I could see Nashville like taking like that division. You know what I mean? Like,
I think Jacksonville.
So. Over Jacksonville.
I know. I like Jacksonville too. I'm not saying I don't. I'm just saying, do they put it all together again and again and again? You know what I mean? Are they consistent with this? They probably are. All right, they probably are.
Tennessee won't be.
I'm just saying. I think Hopkins was better than, let's say, if we're to compare this move to the Julio Jones at the time. You know what I mean?
Yeah, because Julio Jones being brought up, Andre Johnson being brought up, Randy Moss is being brought up.
Yeah, absolutely. They keep doing this, and it keeps not working. So, I mean, I understand. I mean,
fourth time's a charm, I guess.
I mean, they did go to the playoffs with Julio. Do you know what I mean? It just didn't
Julio
work.
Didn't,
you know
and that's because of Julio.
It wasn't only. Yeah, it was mostly Derrick Henry.
Get the ball, Derrick Henry got the way. Listen.
Derrick Henry just carries that team on his damn back. I mean, what can I say other than thank you for letting me watch football and let me pick you in fantasy. I appreciate you. You make my Sundays happier, Derrick Henry. Thanks.
I don't understand how a wide receiver of D-Hop's caliber who wants to ring chase goes to a team with a very unstable quarterback.
That's a great question.
Don't know who's starting either.
How long they'll start too?
Before somebody else comes in.
Exactly. We don't know who's starting yet.
Maybe musical chairs and the shit.
We have so many questions about the rest of that offense. It's Robert Woods is gone too, right?
Yep.
Treylon Burks is the number two now. The rookie last year.
Hey. He was all right, but he was an
I got Johnny Smith though. I don't know the Falcons.
Okay, but we don't know who their quarterback's gonna be.
Their offensive line is trash.
Iffy.
I don't
very iffy. Their defense is. I don't know what he is expecting from this defense. Like, when you have such a terrible offense, your defense is going to suffer because they're going to be on the field all the time. They're going to be tired. They're going to be
beat.
They're going to be battered. They're going to be bruised.
That's valid.
Terrible move. Go get your money, my brother.
Yep. We have you got paid, but you're not winning anything.
I don't know. I think they're if they're not one, they're number two in the division. I don't know. I don't believe in.
No, for sure they can be number two in the division.
I don't believe in Houston. I don't believe in. You know what I mean?
Even though, hear me out. I actually think Indianapolis is going to be number two in that division.
Ooh,
I would be surprised.
I'd like to see that predict. I like that.
Yeah, I think Jonathan Taylor has a nice bounce back year. So.
I'm for competition. I'm for everyone getting better. And I mean, I don't think this makes Tennessee get that much better. You know what I mean? But
it doesn't make them get better at all.
Yeah, I mean, Hopkins is something. You know what I mean?
He's gonna. You know what I mean? He's the quarterback to get him the ball. Like,
yep. It's going to be, yeah.
And also, this isn't the same DeAndre Hopkins that carried the Texans and Cardinals with bad quarterbacks. This is older DeAndre Hopkins.
First of all, he never really had a bad quarterback with the Texans either.
Did he?
Who was his quarterbacks?
It was a whole musical chairs of quarterbacks. Ryan Mattis, yeah. Patrick.
He did have
Patrick. He's not a bad quarterback.
He's not a bad quarterback.
Ryan Mallett was never the starter.
But he did.
He was supposed to say he had
He still did his numbers with Mallett, don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
When did he come in?
Who was from like Ryan Fitzpatrick to Deshaun Watson?
Matt Schaub, I think.
Matt, was he there for Schaub? Because it might have been Schaub to then Fitzpatrick to then Watson.
That's what I think it was. I'm looking it up right now.
Okay. I think you're right. Short he might have been there for the last year of Schaub's.
Long story short, he probably had 10 quarterbacks in Houston. Maybe 7 max. He had a lot. But yeah, this is not young D Hop anymore. The one that, you know, carry you day in, day out. This is older D Hop. He's not, you know, the same D Hop.
I'm interested to see what he does with Will Levis if he works with them.
He came in 2013.
Okay.
Gotcha.
He ain't carry nobody that year.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
He's a rookie. So, yeah. Hear that. I mean, Calvin Johnson was on
that. That was Matt Schaub year. That was Matt Schaub and Case Keenum.
Oh, yeah.
Case
Keenum.
Okay.
2014 was, I think that was still Matt Schaub. Oh, that was Ryan Fitzpatrick, actually.
There you go. Yeah.
2015 was Brian Hoyer. He's not a bad quarterback either. He wasn't terrible.
He's serviceable.
He was very mid.
He was mid. Yeah. There you go.
He's the white Tyrod Taylor right there.
You think? That's
he's a little worse than Tyrod Taylor.
Right? Yeah, thank you. I would say Tyrod, maybe Fitzpatrick.
He was a Patriots backup for so long. Remember that.
let's see here. I forgot what year I'm in. Brock Osweiler, 2016.
I mean,
which he came after that. That was after his Broncos year. Yeah. He came in and just stunk it up.
Yeah, he did.
Oh, and he was a bad quarterback.
Hopkins did carry him for that.
And then the year after that was Tom Savage and Deshaun Watson.
And then Deshaun Watson era.
Oh my God, Tom Savage. He was a Rutgers quarterback.
But I remember because Deshaun Watson got hurt.
So he missed
like half the season. Yeah. His rookie year, he got hurt. I think his torn ACL or something, missed half the season.
Damn.
Yeah. So, hey, I mean, we'll see what D-Hop shows up. It'd be crazy.
But that's
terrible. It's just a terrible move.
Yeah. How do you feel about the running backs not getting paid before we move on? We'll do drafts and brackets.
Saquon was just asking for 16. Y'all offered him 14. Y'all could have came up 2 mil.
I think they only get
Daniel Jones 40, but you couldn't give Saquon 16. That's cool.
43 too.
Y'all couldn't give Saquon 16. No, that's cool. When he leaves, y'all don't feel it. Y'all are gonna feel it. And it hurts me to say.
Preach.
Like, because I'm not a Giants fan. We all know this. But I do love Daniel Jones and I do love Saquon. When he leaves, y'all are gonna feel it. And I'm not gonna feel bad.
You know I'm feeling it right now. Yeah. I'm going through shit knows. Right now. I'm
going through shit right
now. Hey, Saquon, we got a spot at the Jets if you want it. You feel me? You and Breece.
You always welcome.
Damn, I do not want to deal with that.
Could you imagine?
You and Breece, pull up.
There's rumors about Cook. Did you know that?
Yeah, I know. I'm not
about
no rumors.
Okay, understandable. I hear the rumors.
There was rumors that him and Diop wanted to sign on the same team, and now the Titans. Cook is not on there.
Yeah,
Cook couldn't go there to sit the bench. Like,
exactly, he's not gonna do that. The other running back, Josh Jacobs.
Yeah.
He doesn't even want to be in Vegas. So,
yeah, I don't blame him.
You know, I'm not really mad at him not signing a contract because he doesn't want to be there anyway.
Yeah. After his last interview as a Raider,
I would just play under the tag. You feel me? And you'll be out of there in a year, or they might tag you again next year.
No, the 2024 free agent class is going to be loaded.
Yeah,
Derrick Henry, Pollard,
Derrick Henry's not leaving Tennessee.
Saquon, I know. I'm saying in general.
Yeah, I know.
And Eckler and Jonathan Taylor.
Oh, Eckler's definitely.
Would not be surprised if Derrick Henry did leave though.
Really? For who?
Ring chase, man.
Oh, okay, ring chase. Understandable. Could be.
Like, at the end of the day, this is just me thinking. it gets to a point where you have made enough money and you kind of do want to ring to cement your legacy.
Absolutely.
Like, if I was in the league, after, especially, you know how running backs don't, they don't really like to pay running backs after 30 anyway.
Sure.
Once I hit that 28, 29 area, they're not going to really give me 15 mil a year anymore.
Exactly.
Mil a year anymore. So I'm going to find the best situation for me to be able to win a ring.
I hear that.
And I don't know where Derrick Henry's going to end up. It won't be like a Buffalo. It won't be like a Kansas City. But it'll be probably something like a...
Cincy?
Who?
Cincy? Cincinnati?
That's not a bad idea. Cincinnati's not a bad idea.
Get Joe Mixon out of here. Trading Derrick Henry.
That's really not a bad idea. It could be like a... It won't be like the 49ers, but like it'll be like a solid NFC team, I think. Like, who is a solid? Like the Vikings.
Sure.
And like boost up their running game, something like that.
Oh, they probably need it because who knows how Madison's going to do this year.
No, I think Madison's going to be amazing. He's going to be amazing. Elijah called this last year.
Madison's going to be amazing.
Yeah, he called this last year.
Okay, I could not wait for this man to be a starter in this league.
Once they cut Cook, I was like, wow, Elijah called that. That's crazy how he called that.
I said he either leaves or Cook is cut. And either way, because, bro, whenever Cook went out with an injury, Madison stepped up and we didn't even miss him. I'm not a Vikings fan. But they didn't even miss him.
Let me tell you, you had him in fantasy. So you did not miss him. You know what I mean? Like,
exactly.
He showed up for you.
Exactly.
Oh, my God.
All the time. Madison was always there. So.
Right.
The last one, Tony Pollard. Play under the tag for a year, you feel me?
A dip.
Like, that's – Tony Pollard's in a different situation, though. He was the backup, so now it's kind of like they're really giving him a prove-yourself year. And this is an understandable prove-yourself year. Whereas with Saquon and Josh Jacobs, have already proved themselves.
Facts.
So they don't need to play under this tag.
He had a good year this year, but can you repeat it?
But
Pollard is the – you're the A back and the B back right now. So
no more Zeke.
What you got to do?
And he wants to be the back on the Cowboys. You know what I mean? Like, he wants to play for America. Like, he would love that. He's ready. He waited his turn, and now it's – oh.
Hey, we'll see how it goes. So, we have about, 20-something minutes. Do we want to – we had a draft, a man cover draft, and two brackets scheduled. Do we want to cut up the draft?
I want to do the brackets. I
want to do the bracket. What was the first draft?
It was a man cover draft, but we can say that for Madden drops. Okay. So –
We did that already.
We did?
Not Madden, but we did covers of video games already.
Oh, yeah. We can say that for Madden drops because, you know, speaking of Madden, Ball Central Gaming Channel. Madden coming out soon. We'll be on that.
Nice.
So we'll do me and John, we picked the draft. We picked the brackets before the show. We will go first with the most underrated NBA player. It probably is last season because I don't know if it's all time. So we're going to pull that bracket up first. And then the last one will be NFL wide receivers 2023.
So. And we'll do majority votes.
Okay.
Whatever works for y'all.
Just a little plug, you feel me? We're not sponsored by them or anything. But there's this website, crossovergrid.com, bro. If anybody wants to do, you know, grid challenges, like how we do on here sometimes, you know?
I remember our grid era.
That is a great website to do that. That's what they have NBA, they have NFL, and they have hockey as well.
Wait, is that the one where Mookie Betts did?
Oh, with
the players, he does like the Immaculate Grid Challenge. Is that the same one as the one that Mookie Betts does?
Maybe
he did that with Lindor. Are you talking about that one? I saw that.
Yeah, because they did a grid challenge with Lindor.
They only did like two things though, and then they cut out. I was like, finish the grid, let's go. Come on, Lindor.
Right.
My intermezzo.
Okay. I'm sitting here actually doing it right now. Who was a Pelican and a Warrior?
Such a good question. Do you want help or?
No, I don't want help.
Okay. Sorry. That's what I mean. Like, it's that's
how you can just help. Google. Okay, so let me know what pops up for you guys.
It kind of just
floating. I think this is probably last year. So who was the most underrated player off of last year?
Norman Powell. Malik Monk was hooping, don't get me wrong. But
I would say Malik Monk, but that's just because he was hooping. I don't know. I don't know.
I think it really came down to the fact that when PG and Kawhi were out, who really stepped up?
Yeah. I would go with Norman as well.
Okay, understandable. It's fine. So good.
He was with because we know how long, how much PJ Kawhi missed time. He stunned them. Okay, so we'll go here. Okay, next one. Oh, we know where Elijah's going.
Rui.
Oh wow, that's your boy.
As for underrated, bro, yeah, Rui.
Yeah, dude,
Rui
yeah.
as underrated, yeah. sure.
I agree with that. It was Rui.
I do like Grant though.
Especially in the Warrior series, he showed up. What about two Hawks? Aaron Holiday or Onyeka Okongwu?
Worst part is I don't actually know. I'm not familiar with either of their games.
The Hawks is a defensive guard.
Okongwu was a defensive anchor last year. I'm gonna go Okongwu.
Okay, we'll go with Okongwu.
That's fine with me. I was really like when it comes to the Hawks, I'm really just Trey or nothing. So
okay. Then we got Jaden McDaniels or Kevon Looney.
This is tough, actually. Because McDaniels was hooping, but Kevon Looney was like,
I'm gonna go Looney because he had more of a playoff impact. Because Jaden McDaniels punched to a fire hydrant at the end of the year, fire case.
Wait, he did that? That was that? No, yeah. I'm gonna go Looney then.
I'm going Looney.
That's fair.
Yeah, the health situation. It was after the Rudy Gobert.
Didn't Amari Stoudemire do that too?
We know where Phil's going here, but the answer is Bruce Brown.
Is it? Yeah, it is. It's Bruce Brown.
The answer is Bruce Brown, yeah. Pain.
Oh, it's close, Phil. Darren White, pretty damn underrated, though.
Okay, next one. Jakob Poeltl or Ayo Dosunmu?
Jakob had more of a box score impact.
Yeah. I feel like AO was in and out of the lineup because of the whole Lonzo Ball situation and Levine.
Yeah.
And Pat Bev was in Chicago as well. So, yeah, I'm going Jakob.
Sure.
Okay. Next one. Tyus Jones or Javonte Green?
Definitely Tyus Jones.
Tyus Jones.
Tyus. Yeah. The new wizard.
No, he was definitely probably a great back bunker.
Okay, next one, Royce O'Neal or Colin Sexton?
Colin Sexton didn't really play enough for me, and I do love Royce O'Neal. Ooh. I feel like I'd be a little biased on this, so I'll let you guys pick.
I mean, if I had to pick, I'd pick Colin Sexton, but we're talking about underrated, so probably Royce O'Neal. You know what I mean? He's not a huge name, you know what I mean? But he's...
Yeah, that's why I'm going Royce.
Yeah, I'll go Royce O'Neal. That's fine, even though he's a net.
Petty. Yeah, Cam Johnson.
Super easy.
Yeah.
I wanted to be Larry Nance, but unfortunately not. I like that story. I like
him. Oh, John. Who are we picking, John?
I mean, bro, no offense to me quickly, but I mean you could say Fultz, but I mean there's draft guards in Orlando. Do you know what I mean? They're trying to get rid of that dude.
I would have to go IQ.
I gotta go Fultz.
You can go Fultz. That's fine.
No, both of you just took IQ. So
I know. Majority rules. We're gonna do majority rule. No, sorry. That's right. He'll get bounced next round. Don't worry about it.
He probably will. Yeah. Steven Adams or Naz Reid?
Naz Reid.
Steven Adams fan. You can go Naz Reid.
Steven Adams was really out of that lineup a lot.
Yeah.
Oh, last year, yeah, he was. Fuck, my bad. I just like him as a player. He's so funny.
Hey, who doesn't? He's a good player to be around.
I hate to say that I watched the Grizzlies more than I watched the Hawks last year.
Ew. Right. Listen. JB
Brunson.
I wouldn't consider him underrated. Would you consider him underrated?
I would consider him underrated. He was a top 5 point guard last year.
He was John Boyd, but yeah. I mean, people are giving him his due.
He played like a top 5 point guard, but nobody really had him up there.
That's facts.
Bones Highland or Cam Thomas? Cam Thomas had like a good 4-game skid and then just fell off the earth.
I get that, but I really like Cam.
It's Bones, yeah. Yeah, he had like 4 good games and then never heard from him again.
Nobody gave Bones his credit like they should have.
Yeah.
Who's this?
Nick Claxton or Quentin Grimes?
Ooh. Nick Claxton, I mean.
I like
Claxton. I already picked two Knicks. So
this is
like,
a great matchup, though.
It's a great matchup.
The Claxton was like he had early in the season, he was like defensive player of the year candidate.
Yeah, but Gordon Grimes was like he was all about defense. Like he like hurt himself and then stole the ball. I mean, and he can shoot.
I like the way he shoots.
It's Clax for me.
Go Clax.
It can't go Clax. Yeah. Already have two next in the row. I'm fine with it.
Okay, we got Wendell Carter Jr. or Bogdanovich.
For me, Bogdanovich. I like Wendell Carter Jr.'s game,
though. I'd go Wendell, low key. This is the wrong Bogdanovich to be on here. Bojan was the underrated one.
I'll pick Wendell. We'll go Wendell, majority.
Okay.
Hey, Dante DiVincenzo didn't play for the Heat?
No, he played for the Warriors last year.
He didn't play for the Heat at all?
No.
I could have sworn he was in a Heat jersey.
Herb Jones, right? Or maybe I'm wrong.
Yeah, Herb Jones, right?
It's not no disrespect to Christian Wood either. Like, this is actually Herb Jones is the answer here.
He's really coming up defensively. Okay, next round.
I'm glad I got that, though.
Nick Claxton or Congo? Probably Clax.
Yeah.
Sure.
Okay. Next one, Bones Highland or Jakob Poeltl?
Bones Highland, personally.
Gotta, yeah, me too.
Yeah, Bones.
I mean, you're part of a championship team. You're definitely going to get the hype this year.
Nas Reed or Royce O'Neal? I'm going Nas.
Ooh, good.
I'm going Nas.
I can go Nas. Yeah.
Yeah, he got paid this offseason, too.
He did.
Cam or Looney?
Cam.
Cam, right?
Cam. Whoa.
Cam did not get the credit he was due. So
right. Herb or Tyus?
This is an amazing matchup.
This is an amazing matchup. I want to go Tyus. I feel like he was the second, like, as backup point guards go, he was one of the best backup point guards.
Tyus Jones is going to show us something in Washington for
us. Like,
oh, my God.
Yeah. And Herb Jones.
Herb Jones is a good player, though.
He really did well with Zion out.
He did. He stepped
this
up.
This is so tough.
Honestly, I wouldn't be mad at either one, but I'll have to lean Tyus.
Cool. Yeah, both picked it. I'm not picking.
Okay, cool.
But saved it for me. The Battle of the Knicks. John,
who Brunson, you baby. Who you Brunson. Brunson. Yeah. Oh, quickly stepped up at times. So, I mean, Brunson, yeah, though.
Me, yeah, I will say it again, bro. Brunson played like a top 5 point guard.
He did. He made his $100 million contract look like chump change, too. He was like, exactly. Pay me again.
He, like, it was literally top 5 point guards last year. In my eyes, was Luka,
okay.
Steph,
okay.
Ja.
Okay. Jalen. Yeah. Well,
wait, who else? Who was
can we count Ja as a top 5 point guard last year?
Yes, he was good last year. He was. He came back, too.
Trey is number 5 for me.
Yeah, I like it. Rui or Wendell? Probably Rui.
Rui
was hoping when he got to LA, man.
Yeah, I loved him in the Warrior series. He balled out.
And this answer right here is Norman Powell. I'm sorry.
Ooh, Nuggets fans not gonna like
I'm fine with that. I'm fine with that.
Yeah, Norman
Powell. I gotta go Norman Powell, though.
Yeah, we didn't see Bruce Brown without Jokic or Jamal Murray. We saw Norman Powell without PG.
We're gonna see it this year. We're gonna see what Bruce Brown's made of. $22 million. That's it.
Nice okay. matchup.
Norman
nice
Powell, matchup. Nas.
Nice matchup.
Elijah, who are you thinking?
I'm taking.
Honestly. I'm going to go Norman. Just because I feel like Norman Powell is more important to the Clippers than Nas Reed is to the Wolves. Just because you have Kat and Gobert already.
And that would actually mean that you're going with Nas Reed in the end because he's underrated. That's
oh, sorry.
Oh man. I'm gonna have to go Nas Reed on this one.
John, who are you thinking? Nas?
You took Nas Reed too?
Yeah.
No, I'm asking Phil.
Oh no. He took Norman Powell.
You can decide. I mean, I'm fine with
I picked Norman. Going
either way. Do you? All right.
Tiebreaker, John.
Ah, damn it. I'm gonna go Nas Reed. I'm sorry.
Okay, that's fine. I'm not upset about that pick. Cam and Tyus.
It was closer than I thought.
Now we're into the tough ones.
This is tough, and you're gonna say I'm wrong. I'm going Tyus.
I'm going Tyus.
Yeah, fair enough. I would go Tyus too.
Like when I tell you that he's gonna go crazy in Washington, bro.
Him and Jordan.
I agree with you.
Claxton or Bones?
Oh, tough one.
It's really Bones.
It is.
Okay, we'll go Bones Highland.
But I do think Brooklyn's building something. And if that kind of freaks me out a little bit.
Do you know my vote?
We know your vote.
Yep, thank you.
Do not be mad at me, but I'm going Rui for this one.
It's fine, I guess. Phil?
In terms of being underrated, I have to go Rui.
Yeah, Rui.
He plays on a team with LeBron James. Of course, no one's going to take him seriously. Is that wrong to say?
I mean, that's a couple.
Because even when he was in Washington.
What'd you say?
Oh, even when he was in Washington,
he would still be underrated. Like, yeah, I guess he was.
Yeah. I mean, him picking Rui's compliment here because Jalen Brunson did, you know, deserves credit for, you know, like Elijah said, top five point guard of all last year.
He does. I'm not mad at it. You can pick Rui. Yeah. It's fine.
Go Rui.
That's ridiculous.
I think Jalen Brunson passed the underrated era already. Tyus?
No. Yeah, Tyus, personally.
Man, I think Ty is going to win this bracket for me.
He might.
It looks like
he's good. He's damn good.
Because this is Rui and
Ty. Yeah. Okay. Rui?
See, I don't know.
This one's tough, but it's still Rui.
Yeah.
Because Rui could have easily averaged 20 and 10.
I guess, yeah.
Yeah.
I guess, sure, Rui.
Yep, Rui.
He played more ball. I mean, realistically.
People forget, too. When he was out there in Washington with Russ running that pick and roll, bro,
it was good.
The answer's Tyus.
Yeah, Tyus. I go Tyus.
Hey, there's your winner.
When Rui was out there in Washington with Russ running that pick and roll, bro, he was doing numbers.
Hey, Tyus Jones is your winner.
But Tyus Jones definitely needs more minutes.
Tyus Jones is done in Washington.
It's gonna be something really good
this season. Oh man, y'all gonna be.
What's the projected stat line?
I don't know, Elijah. Do you want to go with that? Do you want to? What do you think there's a stat line prediction?
Let's go 19.
I'm gonna say 19-8 and 4.
Oh, right. Yeah. Okay, that'd be really good.
Okay, now we're gonna do NFL wide receivers. This is the one John picked for 2023. We're doing how they played last year. Like who was – or how do we want to decide how they're good they're going to be this year or who had the best season last year? How do you want to decide this?
It's hard. I don't know. I think
– I want to go with how I think they're going to go this year.
Okay.
I think last year should be part into it though. Do you know what I mean? Like –
I mean,
depending
it will
on who
be.
They face. Okay, I'm just laying out. All right, cool. That's what's up.
Okay.
I'm willing to do both. I like that.
Sad to say that Jettis is going to win if he's on here, but
he probably will. Yeah.
The answer here is Alan Lazard.
Thank you. I would agree.
He was hooping.
Because without Alan Lazard, Rodgers was a little lost. To be honest,
absolutely. Oh, this one's easy.
Super easy.
Damn, they said fuck. This is legit and easy for
sure. And it's no disrespect to Drake London, but
yeah, he was damn good.
Nelson Aguilar.
This is super easy. Get that Patriot out of here.
Oh, Nelson Aguilar. He used to be former Eagle.
Raider. Yep.
He's now a Raider, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
This is easy. Oh damn, it's not easy.
It's not easy.
I'm sorry.
It's not easy.
I'm sorry.
Garrett Wilson.
Pause. It's AJ.
It is AJ, but it's Garrett Wilson. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Garrett Wilson. He had no quarterback.
As a Jets fan.
You know Zach Wilson was garbage. You know what's his face couldn't throw the damn ball at the end of the year. He still caught everything. All right. This guy is how many fucking rookie of the weeks this guy got? Stop.
It hurts me to say that AJ is better than Garrett Wilson. He will be better. AJ is arguably top five.
Who do you think has a better year? Deadass. This might be a bet because Aaron Rodgers coming in.
Who has a better year?
Yeah. I mean, we're factoring in past and future. You know what I mean?
Let's see. With the Jets.
You think Alan it's AJ Lazard, Brown?
Garrett Wilson.
Oh, so last year, Garrett Wilson, 1,100 yards, 4 touchdowns. AJ Brown last year, 1,400 yards, 11 touchdowns. Going
I think Garrett Wilson can get 10 touchdowns this year. I'm being dead ass.
He can.
Yeah, I think he can get
but
more.
AJ
than that.
Is still the number one in Philly.
Yeah.
And Jalen
I get that, but as
Jalen Hurts is about to be healthy again,
I understand, and I'm a huge Jalen Hurts fan. But hear me out on this with Jalen Hurts. All right. Devontae Smith he's pretty damn good number two. He's bordering number one stat. They have two number ones in Philly.
Honestly, my pick would be AJ Brown.
Okay. You could have AJ Brown.
Listen, they have two number ones in Philly, but
Garrett Wilson's
good. That's all I'm saying.
Offense is wide open in Philly.
Garrett Wilson could have a good year though.
We might have to make that a bet though. I mean, if you want to go down that road, I'm just saying.
This is one of the worst matchups ever.
Yeah.
Because I don't like Chase. Right. I don't like Chicago. Period.
I like Chase.
I think they didn't do much.
No, I like Chicago. Sorry, but they need a few years. Yeah.
Honestly, I would be mad.
D-Hop's decision at all.
Neither do I.
I'm gonna go D-Hop though.
In fact, you're so much in
issue. Yeah, D-Hop is still the better receiver. Let's see. Next one, DJ Moore.
Okay.
Yeah.
Justin Jefferson? You mean the guy that's gonna win this whole damn thing? Yeah.
Probably. Yeah.
Scary Terry.
No disrespect, Mr. Burks.
Yep. Hey, your back is helping you now.
CD.
CD.
Yeah.
Michael Pittman Jr. Ha ha ha. I mean, not trying to be like that.
MPJ.
Ooh. Oh, yeah, Brown.
Yeah, both say Brown.
Ross,
say
Brown.
Yeah. Amon Ross, easy. So next, we got Devin Duvernay. Oh, Christian Kirk.
Christian Kirk, easily.
He's gonna have
made fun of Christian Kirk last year when he went.
Absolutely, the contract he signed.
This is hard. Ooh. Cooper Kupp. I mean, it's Cooper Kupp, but Amari Cooper had a damn good last year.
As long as Matt Stafford is a quarterback, it's Cooper Kupp.
Yeah, I got that.
Yeah, but he should be healthy coming in next season.
Yeah, he should be.
Yeah, I don't pass on that old line. Oh,
there you go.
I love George Pickens too, man. Sorry,
NFL young boy. Pickens.
Wait. Oh, Brandon Cooks might have a fire year in Dallas too, though.
He might be at number two.
Like Debo's still the number one in San Francisco, so he will be better. It's Devontae here.
I hate their quarterbacks.
Jimmy G is gonna make Devontae look good again. It's Diggs. Thank you.
Stephon
Diggs, yeah. But I don't know about good. I mean, he was already good. I don't know.
Is that Mike Williams?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Real Courtland Sutton.
I'd take Mike Williams over Courtland Sutton this year.
No.
Take anybody over a Broncos receiver.
I think Russ is going to have a bounce back year or a better year than he had last year.
Have a better year for sure, but I'm taking Mike Williams for sure. Okay. Mike Williams in the red zone is a scary, scary
matchup
for any DB, bro. All right.
He's not there enough for me. Sorry.
Hey, fair enough. Injury problems is fair. I completely agree with that, John.
Even though you trade him for
Aaron Rodgers? I did for Aaron Rodgers. I made that work. Do you know that? That's crazy.
Okay, so the answer here is Christian Kirk.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
Are you sure?
It's Lazard.
Is it?
It's Lazard, yeah. In New York, yeah.
It could go either way on this field. So what are you thinking?
Keep in mind, Christian Kirk also has Calvin Ridley coming back.
He does to compete with.
Where's Alan Lazard on the depth chart? Number two or three?
He's one.
He's one technically. As of right now, before they throw anyone on the ball, I think it's him, Wilson, Corey Davis. I forget who's next. I think that's
McCole Hardman is three, actually.
You think so? You think over Corey Davis?
Hardman is three.
I don't know if I believe that. I have to see that with my eyes, bro.
I saw Christian Kirk's season last year.
I've seen Corey Davis show up. I don't know. I'm for whatever Jet shows up. You know what I mean? But like,
Be Hardman. Of course, no. What did Christian Kirk's stats last year? 1108 with 8 touchdowns.
I could go either way on this one.
Was a large touchdown.
Probably Lazard, because he's got the Aaron Rodgers connection.
So,
okay, we'll Lazard then.
At least for 1 year. You know what I mean? Maybe next year it's Christian Kirk.
Looking on ourlads.com, it looks like Garrett Wilson, Alan Lazard, and McCole Hardman are the top three.
Okay.
Then you got Corey Davis, Denzel Mims, and Randall Cobb behind them.
Oh, I forgot Cobb's there.
Cobb is there, yeah.
He's only there. We know why he's there. I don't know why Phil's still sitting on this screen.
Yeah.
You don't need us to answer.
Yeah, we know.
Here.
Come on. Don't even let us vote on this, Phil. Come on. Although, good vote.
Oh, my gosh.
Good vote one. Fudge.
Let me pull up the stats real quick.
If I go Tyreek Hill, I might have to go Tyreek
Hill. Before I make a decision, I'm going to pull
up. Or I like Jamar Chase as well. You honestly can't go.
Also, Tyreek Hill said he's trying to go for 2,000 yards this year.
Yeah. Well,
so Tyreek Hill, 1,700 yards and 10 touchdowns. Go ahead, Elijah. I'll pull up the stats.
Tyreek is going to get the ball more than Jamar will.
Probably will.
You got to think about those end arounds.
Yeah. And Jamar Chase, 1,009 touchdowns. So Tyreek had more yards, but Chase had more touchdowns.
I don't think Chase is seasoned enough. I think he's got so many more years to like get better. You know what I mean? I think Tyreek Hill's in his prime. I would agree. I would go with Tyreek Hill.
It's so tough, bro.
In
terms of just catching the ball and getting touchdowns, I gotta go Jamar Chase.
Sure.
But in terms of an overall player, because we know Tyreek Hill is going to do more, give me Tyreek Hill.
Yeah, I agree with Tyreek.
Well, also,
what John said, Chase is not even in his prime yet.
Yeah. We can vote for Chase next year. No, and on top of it, Tyreek Hill came into defense of Tua. Remember when that pass that the social media team put out that stupid clip?
It's Davante Adams. Go ahead.
Davante Adams. Another guy. I think DK has a couple more years until
he's in his prime.
It's Diggs. Don't
it's
even.
Diggs. It's Diggs. I do think AJ Brown is pretty damn good, though.
He is good, yeah.
He's not better than Diggs.
No, but not better. Yeah, of course.
Especially he's a bigger body. Don't get me wrong.
Bro. Absolutely. Coop.
I'm sorry, Cooper Kupp. Yeah.
Yeah, probably. Coop. Oh, man. I want to say Amon-Ra now because both of you said Coop.
Well, we voted you out, sorry.
Yeah, I don't care. You vote me out. Y'all both said Coop. I said Amon-Ra. That's my pick.
NFC East wide receivers.
I'm going CD. Terry needs to get out of Washington, man. Free Terry.
I kind of agree with that, actually. Exactly what Elijah said.
He needs to get rid of quarterback, indeed.
Although, what if Sam Howell's good?
We'll find out, I guess.
Maybe he's not.
Free Terry.
Yeah.
He's a better, right?
It's not okay.
This is the same thing with the Tyreek Hill thing. I think Mike Williams is probably a better receiver.
Debo's better all around, though. Yeah.
Yeah, but who's been on the field for a long period of time? Like, I feel like
Williams. Yeah, that's the only downside for Mike.
What? You think Mike Williams has been on the field longer than Debo?
I thought you meant like who's been playing longer. Yeah, Mike.
No. I meant like
Mike Williams been in the league for
the last two seasons. Health wise, is what we're talking about here. Come on now.
I mean, we're talking health wise. Yeah, it's Debo, but like I said, it's the same thing. Mike Williams will give you more as a wide receiver, whereas Debo will give you more all around.
Yeah, I'm gonna go Debo just because the whole all around aspect.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what we're voting on, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
But again, I'd rather guard. If I'm a DB, I'd rather guard Debo than Mike Williams.
Yeah,
really.
1v1,
really.
Ball thrown up in the air. I'd rather have Debo than Mike Williams. Absolutely. So we go with Devontae.
Yeah.
I don't know. Debo scares me.
Should have left the Packers.
Ooh.
This one is.
This one's hard. You're gonna disagree with me, but I'm gonna go Diggs.
I think that's what Elijah wanted to hear.
That's exactly what I wanted to hear.
I'm sorry.
I just think the connection
between Josh Allen and Stephon Diggs are just is.
And,
I mean,
and we know that Josh Allen will be on the field longer than Tua. We know, health wise. But
listen, my thing is, we know Tyreek Hill is gonna give you way more all around.
I don't know.
But as a pure wide receiver, I'm taking Diggs.
Absolutely.
But I think I think the decision here for me would be Tyreek Hill, because like I said, as an all around player, Tyreek Hill will give you more.
I just think when it
jet sweeps, those little touch passes.
Sure.
Yes. Yeah. Gotta give that to Tyreek.
Whatever wide receiver I would have, Tyreek.
Really? Wow. That's crazy.
And keep in mind, if we're talking pure wide receiver.
Who's the number two in Buffalo? That's what I want to know.
Gabe Davis?
Is he? That's a horrible number two. I'll tell you that right now.
Gabe
Davis is a good number two? What?
Gabe Davis is a good number two.
Get out of
here. Josh Allen just has to learn how to distribute the ball a little bit more.
Yeah, that's great. Also, Gabe Davis had a lot of drops.
He was very consistent last year.
Yeah, but then, then he'll one game just bust out.
Yep, absolutely.
Two catches, two touchdowns, 170 yards.
But like every other game, it's Stephon Diggs. Nope. That's why I would put Stephon over Tyreek. But that's just me.
Fair enough. So we're going to JJ here.
Yes. JJ is really going to win this whole thing.
Absolutely. It's probably going to be him versus Chase. Not going to lie to you.
And right here, it's
CD person.
Because of the, I have to use the same logic I just used. It's Debo.
Okay.
But I would not be surprised if CD did have a better year.
Yeah.
With CMC coming into the fold, and George Kittle hopefully staying healthy. Brandon Ayuk is the number two. Hey, man.
No one says healthy in terms of this. You can go either way on this one. But
I'm going to go Debo. Because all around.
Sure. I mean, I agree. I mean, jump ball.
Debo's getting knocked out the next round anyway. It's okay.
Yeah. Oof. I'm going to go Tyreek Hill here.
Man.
Sure. Yeah. I mean, I don't know.
Factoring in the quarterback problem as well. I'm going.
I would take Tua over anybody that's on the Raiders right
now. I'd take Tua over, yeah. But will Tua get a concussion? Be done.
But
can get Garoppolo throw 20 yards down the field as well?
Yes, he can. Yes, he can. Don't do that. Yes, he
can. Say his name again.
When Brock Purdy. But I mean, before Brock Purdy, Jimmy G had the 49ers roll.
Yeah.
I do think Jimmy G is the AFC's Kirk Cousins.
Oh, that's not a bad comparison.
Very underrated. That's
not a bad comparison.
Very underrated. He'll get his numbers. He'll do
what
he
can he get it
do.
Done? What can
but at
he
the, at the end of the day.
Isn't the same division as Mahomes? Absolutely not.
All right, so I'm going to need one of you to pick one.
Because... I picked Tyreek already.
Okay, you picked Tyreek. Then click on him.
Who'd you pick?
Who did you guys pick?
I kind of gone either way. That's what I said. I mean,
Elijah,
you got to pick one.
I mean, if I had to pick one, I'd say Tua over anybody that the Raiders had. So yeah, probably Tyreek.
Tyreek? Okay.
Yeah.
Even though Tua's got a bad.
I'm taking Tay.
Yeah. And then why do you have to disagree? Why? I mean,
because I actually want Davante Adams over Tyreek.
Okay. Cool. Let me just say Davante Adams before I choose.
The same way. Because even if you would have picked Davante Adams, Davante Adams would have won.
Sure. So then let Davante Adams win. He's a top three receiver. I mean, he could get bounced out versus Justin Jefferson anyways.
It's too late now. So Tyreek Hill or Justin Jefferson? On the left.
It's going to be
left.
Justin Jefferson, but whatever. I mean.
Justin Jefferson, man.
There we go. Yeah, I mean, probably. Wait, when did Jamar Chase get knocked out?
Jamar Chase got knocked out by Tyreek Hill.
Ah, there it is. Okay.
Hey, I got a question for you. Did y'all see that video where Joe Burrow was asked, who would you rather have, Javonte Adams, Jamar Chase or Justin Jefferson? And he played the fifth?
Oh.
I play the fifth, too. I don't know.
With Jamar Chase sitting next to him.
Damn. You don't think that might be brought up again?
Nah. Maybe. Who knows?
Oh, you should have backed up your guy. He was right there.
I mean, I guess. Yeah, I mean, he backs him up otherwise. I mean, don't they live on the same block or something?
Man, I don't care if they live on the same – I don't care if they live in the same house. You always take your wide receiver.
Sure.
You don't plead the fifth.
We all know who to take. You would take him. Come on.
He should have said it then.
Well, yeah, but he wants controversy. He wants fun. He wants – you know what I mean?
With his old teammate?
Yeah, it's jokes. You never joke with your teammates? No, you're all serious? That. Oh, come on. It's not that bad. Who asked him the question? Was it someone important?
Brandon Marshall.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Brandon Marshall. Cool.
Brandon Marshall's NBA team.
Brandon Marshall's like a top 10 wide receiver all the time, bro.
He's good. Yeah, he's damn good. I'm not saying he's not. I'm just saying Brandon Marshall is a guy who jokes, and I like Brandon Marshall. So
don't talk about NBA.
He just jokes, and he asks the hard questions sometimes. He knows people are going to answer. He's a player himself. You know what I mean?
That's not a hard question. If I'm Joe Burrow, that's not a hard question.
Okay. I mean.
Double? Yeah.
If I'm freaking Kenny Pickett, I'm taking George Pickens over anybody because that's my wide receiver. That's my guy.
That's my reverse. That's my wide receiver. That's my quarterback. Absolutely. Who knows what happened after that segment as well? Maybe a little backroom talk or locker room talk. So who would you really pick? You know, since the cameras are off and everything.
Even still, I'm not saying another – yo, bro, it's like a relationship for real, man.
Like a quarterback wide receiver chemistry is so important.
I mean, what? Do you think they'd break up ever? Come on.
No.
Exactly. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Anyway,
so,
shout out Francisco Alvarez, feel me, fantasy baseball.
He's Francisco doing amazing. Alvarez,
two home runs today, you feel me?
That's what's up. Congrats.
I definitely put him in my utility slot. Thank you, sir.
He's a catcher for the Mets, right?
Yeah. But he's been picking up his bat lately. Am I right?
Yeah, he's been wilding lately.
Yeah. Hey, good for you. He's the one bright spot.
Luis Robert is back.
Even though they botched him coming up, Elijah. Do you know that? He came up last year against the Braves at the end.
What the hell is going on today?
I don't know.
Wild Atlanta's day. Up 13-12 in the eighth. The Mets are up 11-9.
Nice.
Freaking Detroit is up 9. Nobody's pitching today for real.
Yeah, all the bats are on fire today. So hey, there's a podcast. We did talk some NFL. We did some NFL brackets, NBA brackets as well. Before we head up, last words. Who wants to go first? I'll go first. So me and Elijah are in a 2K league. Playoffs are starting today, I believe. We'll see how it goes. But, you know, we were supposed to have a special guest on this week. So I want to delay a message for our special guest. I will be facing TJ, aka the Sonics, in the 2K League. I just want to say good luck, but at the end of the day, I'm gonna have to do what I have to do as commissioner and one of the best players in the league. I'm gonna have to sweep you. Nothing personal, but I gotta move on to the next round. I gotta do business.
Didn't he beat you?
Once, yeah.
Okay. But you're promising a sweep here live on Ball of Central.
That was the past. We talk about the future. Whenever we play tonight, tomorrow. It's going to be a 2-0 shutout, and then move on to the next round. I'm whooping the Knicks ass the next round, too.
Wow.
And then whoever wins out of the Sixers and Cavs, because I think that's going to be my finals opponent for the East, whoop their ass, too, and then move on and play versus the West. That's the game plan.
Okay. So, well, I'd love to stay updated on that. So, you know, that seems super exciting. Elijah, do you want to go next? Or you want me to go next?
For last good luck, TJ.
I'll go next. I'm going to talk about the 2K League as well.
Okay. Well, that's very exciting, Phil, and I appreciate that. I want to hear from Elijah.
I'm in the West. I'm the 5 seed. I will be facing Phoenix. And, you know, Phoenix is known for not being able to finish a job anyway. Mm-hmm. So, sir, good night. Everybody got – and it's crazy. Everybody in the chat said they got Phoenix money line. Copy.
Wow.
Copy.
Underdog status?
Yep, copy. Absolutely. He's like plus odds.
Whoa. Wait, so Phil said it too?
Phil said it too. Immediately, too. As soon as Phil saw the matchup, he said, "I got Dan." Immediately.
Oh yeah.
Copy.
I'm not. I wasn't in that. I've
played with this guy for 5+ years.
So. I'm a fan of the underdog. All right. So Elijah, I'll be rooting for you. All right.
Thank you.
No problem.
But don't, like, Phil, for real. Don't worry about it.
Oh damn.
Hey, I'm not gonna switch up. I'm not gonna go back. If you win, credit to you.
Don't worry about it.
Phil's about to smoke your boots. I mean, TJ about to smoke your boots.
Someone promising to sweep someone else, you know, beautiful underdog story. I love to hear it. That's what's up.
Well, it's going to be very interesting. Yeah, the playoffs finally started because it's still down a little bit, but I'm excited to see how it plays out. And I think the first match is about to start with the play-in stuff. So between Kings and Warriors, and then we got a created team, Tampa versus the Tar Heels. So I'm excited to see how it plays out tonight. John, what about you? Last words.
Nothing much. Just chilling with some friends this summer. Planning going rafting. Kind of just went out Saturday night. Had a fun time. Went for some drinks. Nothing too much. Just chilling. Not as much excitement as this 2K League sounds with you know, these storylines. I love to hear it. I love to keep updated on it. You know what I mean?
I should be streaming. Well, TJ gets, if we get the play-in done tonight, I'll stream my game with TJ.
Well, good luck, guys. I mean, I'm rooting for both of you. I'm rooting to see what happens.
Wait, so John, between both of us, who would you rather have win this league?
Who would I rather have win between the two of you?
Your Joe Burrow moment. Who would you rather have win?
Who would I rather win between the two of you? All right, Phil. All right, this is the part where you get butt hurt because not that I pick against you. I think you could win this whole tournament. I think, Phil, I've played against you in 2K and other things. You know what I mean? So I'm not counting you out here when I say this, but I'd probably rather have Elijah. Just because, like, I know you won the tournament until the next year when we started the new tournament. So, you know what I mean? So, I mean, I'd probably pick right now Elijah at this moment. You know what I mean? Especially because you said you were going to sweep. So now, Phil, I better see some damn sweeps here, Phil. It better get super clean.
If you don't sweep, we looking at you a little crazy.
We look at you like, Phil.
Understandable. I got to back up my words. Understandable.
I mean, that's all I'm saying. But, I mean, hey, I mean, as of right now, I mean, Elijah underdog story, I would love to. Could you imagine? Everybody else taking everybody else, Elijah just beating people. You know what I mean? That would be awesome. You know what I mean? Knock off two people that maybe don't deserve it. Maybe think they're ahead of the curve because they got an extra two wins
if,
or something.
If he wins this first round matchup, he deserves all the credit in the world. It's probably the toughest first round matchup.
Is it a doozy? Is it like? Is it super like?
In my opinion, it's probably the toughest first round matchup.
Okay. Well, I mean, it's all right. I mean, it's fine. 0-0 starts the game. Let's get it.
We'll give you an update when
I keep in mind when I played Phil, I could not make a shot at all.
That's fine. I mean, bro, Phil plays 2K like
religiously.
Yeah, religiously. Like it's like if you move to Texas and talk to someone about God, football, and the family, it's like you walked into Phil's dorm room and it was like tequila, 2K. And, tequila 2K and great studying. Yeah, probably studying because Phil studied a lot. But
I don't know who told you that. The last part was not true.
I was trying to be nice. Well, all right.
Maybe lost one. In sports. You
the last one. Could have been sports. Could have been something about sports. But yeah, I don't know. Yeah, Phil's very into 2K. So
you're putting your future's bet right now, Elijah.
Yeah, I mean, I'd like to. Why not? I mean, I'm not. I mean, this isn't. I wouldn't. I mean, I'm room for both of you to win. Why not? You know what I mean? I'd like to see a final, Baller Central's final, with the smack talking both ways.
Oh,
I mean, you're both
in
two different divisions. Oh. Am I right?
I wouldn't be
both
bad
in. You're one's in the East, one's in the West. Am I right? So, I mean, yep. I'd love to see a final. I mean, I'm not predicting a final, but I mean, it'd be dope for the channel.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? So,
I mean. Gotcha.
Oh, so Phil, I would love
I want a final with us. I want Phil to get knocked out now.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Because what I said about you, Jay, you want to see your boy in the final.
No, I don't care who I see in the final. I just don't want to see you there.
I understand. I wouldn't want to see him in the final as well. I completely understand. I would be, you know, a little bit threatened if I was facing me in the finals.
No, I need just better comp.
In the West? Are you worried in the West?
I'm fine in the West.
Ooh.
I mean, you know what the best thing about a really competitive matchup in the first round is? The second round is not as competitive, depending on, you know what I mean? I'm just saying.
There are drop-offs. He would face the winner of Vegas and whoever the AC is tonight, whoever went between the Kings and the Warriors.
Sure. But, I mean, you're saying his matchup's hard now, so it's no matter what, it's a little less hard. You know what I mean?
Pause.
True. Right? Or, sorry, yeah, pause, whatever.
Hey, Georgia, we'll keep you.
Shout out, leader, the plug, and Adam 22.
We should. Damn, we had the side pod. We talked about that. We brought that up randomly. That's wild. So is Elijah's turn to hit now? Is that the question? Or Elijah, if Adam 22 hit you up, say, hey, you have a chance to hit.
Hey, man, that's a tough matchup right there. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I mean, going after. You know, Jason Love is going to be pretty tough for you, to be honest. You know, that's, you know, one of the top tier guys, and you have to try to match that performance. It'll be tough. It'll be, you know, it's like LeBron Jordan, you know, Steve. But, hey, I'm actually surprised you brought that. That's more of the boys podcast. So, hey, you know, yeah, shout out Lena the plug. Make your money, you know. So, with that being said, Ball Central Podcast, you can check out all the podcasting platforms down below. And, you know, OnlyFans coming soon, apparently. Elijah shooting a shot at the end of the plug. Also, YouTube, check it out, gaming channel and podcast channel. So with that being said, thank you for tuning in. And we'll see you guys next week on Baller Central.
Yeah!